Hi, I'm in one of my parents' cottages, and one of those dirty, rotten squirrels somehow managed to get into this drawer and couldn't figure out how to get back out. So it decided to chew its way out.
So I brought this drawer to my dad's shop, and I'm going to try to fix it here because it's a long ways from my own shop. I figure if I just cut it off right along this line here, then I'll have a straight line to just put a new piece on here. So I just jigged up the drawer on here so I can make this table saw cut. I had to put some spacers under it because there's a handle on the front, and it's clamped down here and back here, and I used the bevel gauge to make sure I had it at the right angle and a little pencil mark, so I should be cutting up the right amount. So I ended up raising that blade a lot further just so I could get a whole flat surface on here. And now I'm going to need to cut out a triangular section to go on here coming from this piece of wood. So here's what I got so far. It matches the rabbits around it, but I still need to, there's a bit of a molding type shape on here, so I need to kind of reproduce that, and I think I'm going to try that on a table saw. So that overall matches the contour. Now I just need to put a round over on the outside edges. Well, that matches actually pretty close, so I think I'll glue that on. So the plan is to put this on here and clamp it like so. But the glue always lets things slide a little bit, so this thing will want to slide off the end. So I clamped a piece of wood on the end here to act as a stop, and to prevent that piece of wood from getting glued on here from the squeeze out, I wrapped it in a plastic bag. I made another little block just to go in here. That one, I just kind of fit that to size on the belt sander. Now that I got out of the clamps, I see I have a little bit of gap here in places. So to hide that, I'm going to cut a slot here and put an inlay in here and make that a contrasting line so the whole thing looks like some kind of intentional accent. So here's a slot cut. Now my dad never worked with any exotic hardwoods, so the best I could find is this piece of underlay plywood, and it's got dark mahogany on the one side, so I'm gonna glue that in here, and that'll provide a nice contrasting line. Well, I'll call that done. Once varnish is put onto that stuff, it'll match in color a little bit closer. So if you look at this piece of oak and I just put some water on it, that'll show what color it ends up with the varnish. And then with that line to contrast, that'll look kind of neat. So I'm satisfied with how this drawer came out, but it's been a long time since I used my dad's big Felder table saw to make anything. And having gotten used to my smaller Delta table saw, I have to say, I don't really like it that much anymore. The fence on this saw is really hard to adjust, and the blade is hard to get up and down, the crank is really hard, and the table doesn't really slide that easily.
So for smaller jobs, a smaller table saw is actually often the better tool for the job.